The Philippine government's debt reaches a new record high. The total outstanding debt hit 13.64 trillion pesos in November. That's an increase of around 3 billion pesos from the previous month. The Bureau of Treasury cites the impact of the peso's appreciation against the U.S. dollar on foreign currency loans for the marginal increase. Of the total debt, over 9.4 trillion pesos, or over 69%, was borrowed from local lenders, while the remainder was sourced from foreign lenders. The Philippine government and the two houses of Congress will conduct separate probes on the technical issues that triggered hundreds of flight disruptions on New Year's Day. See, a glitch on the air traffic management system of the Ninoy Aquino International Airport caused the cancellation or delay of hundreds of flights, affecting over 65,000 travelers. Transportation Secretary Jaime Bautista says all damaged equipment have been fixed. Malacanang vows a thorough investigation into the incident. Meanwhile, Senator Joel Villanueva has directed the appropriate committees of the Senate to conduct an inquiry on that technical glitch. Senator Grace Poe, the chairperson of the Chamber's Public Services Panel, calls the incident a national security concern. She insists aviation officials should be held accountable. The lower house also looking to begin a probe into the airport chaos.
Ito kasing mga system o equipment na ito, these were bought in 2010, but only installed in 2018. And 4 years thereafter, nagkaroon na itong problema na ganito. We have to find out whether it is true kung outdated na itong sistema na ito. Para sa akin, personal ko lang na iniisip ito. Kasi we just came from a two-year pandemic period. Maybe this equipment were not fully utilized. Marami ng technical advances in so far as this kind of equipment is concerned within a year.
Well, some passengers affected by Sunday's technical glitch remain stranded at the Ninoy Aquino International Airport. Izzy Lee filed this report.
There are passengers still stranded at NAIA who hasn't gone back to their province after a technical glitch occurred in the traffic system of Civil Aviation Authority or CAAP in January 1. Some of them have been outside the terminal for 4 days waiting for a scheduled flight, rain or shine. There are also those who missed a day at work as they still could not take a flight back home. According to some stranded passengers, no one informed them immediately that their flights were delayed or cancelled and no assistance was provided to them. They have used all the money they have for food and have nothing left now.
Wala talagang nag-inform sa amin na ganun talaga yung nangyayari. So naging tanga kami dito. Gutom na kami, pagod na pagod. 6 days po kami dito, ma'am, ang tagal-tagal namin dito kahit paliguan man lang wala.
Ang sa akin lang, kasi malayo pa yung pinanggalingan namin, sana bago yung flight namin, nag-text man lang sila. Simula kahapon, naano na yung leave ko eh. 15 days lang po kasi ako. Ngayon, naano pa, na bawasan pa ng 4 na araw yung 15 days ko. Ulan init ang dinanas namin dito.
Airlines are advising the public to expect more delays on certain flights in the coming days and to monitor flight status online before heading to the airport.
Flight delays still expected in the coming days. Philippine Airlines appealing to passengers for understanding as it tries to get its operations back to normal as soon as tomorrow. It explains it cannot easily rebook passengers affected by the glitch since most flights are already full due to the peak season.
We have carried out some mitigating actions. Number one, nag-set up po tayo ng extra sector flights. These are the extra flights. Pangalawa, may mga iilang flights, nag-upgrade po tayo ng eroplano. Despite all these efforts, hindi naman kaagad ma-accommodate lahat ng mga 24,000 stranded passengers or those affected by these cancellations, no? So we are seeking their understanding. This will take a period of 1 or 2 weeks bago ma-clear yung backlog. Okay. As far as passenger rebooking is concerned.
As for Air Asia, it expects operations to normalize in about 3 to 4 days. It advises passengers to regularly check its website. It also has ground personnel to assist those stuck in airports.
We've been really managing on-ground operations, including starting today mounting of an additional flight to address the canceled flights. We already have about 100 volunteers, aside from our ground operations, namely composed of guest services, pilots, and the cabin crew, maintenance and engineering, everybody's on ground. But more importantly, I think, is that our people office are already helping with regards to customer service interaction. So that actually makes the experience a lot better as we progress.